Hydrogen bonding is the second dominant force behind protein folding, along with the hydrophobic effect. While at first glance hydrogen bonding looks like a simple dipole-dipole interaction, there's actually more to the story that's going to bring in molecular orbital interactions that we'll talk about in this webcast. So looking at the generalized picture of a hydrogen bond you see here, we'll notice that the positive end of the dipole of a hydrogen bond donor aligns with the negative end of the dipole of a hydrogen bond acceptor to form the hydrogen bond. And as this little equation at the top of the slide notes, a hydrogen bond is partially charge attraction. So this portion of hydrogen bond energy comes from the interaction of the dipoles. We have a dipole aligned from the acceptor towards the donor like so. However, there's more to the story. And the deeper component here is the N to sigma star interaction that takes place during a hydrogen bond. We know that such an interaction takes place because the geometry of hydrogen bonds is very constrained. We can't merely align the negative end of the acceptor's dipole, which in this case would actually align this way, with the positive end of the donor's dipole. What we actually need to do is align the N orbital of the acceptor with the sigma star orbital on the donor in order to develop an N to sigma star orbital interaction in the hydrogen bond. This is where the partial covalent bond character in hydrogen bonding comes from. Here you see a J-mol image containing three water molecules. Zero in on water 3 and water 2. You may notice that the OH bond of water 3 looks perfectly aligned to be a hydrogen bond donor with respect to water 2's oxygen, which can act as an acceptor. However, if we turn the view slightly, what we can see is that this is not an optimal alignment. The lone pair on water 2, which would be extending out somewhere this way, is not well overlapped with the sigma star orbital of water 3's oxygen-hydrogen bond. In order to achieve that, we need to rotate water 2 about 40 degrees, and now the lone pair on water 2 is perfectly aligned with the OH bond in water 3. This is the optimal alignment to form a hydrogen bond between waters 2 and 3. Similarly with water 1, we need to bring the sigma star into alignment with water 2's N orbital, which on the right-hand side would be extending off in this direction. So we need to rotate water 1 as well so that its OH sigma bond is pointing directly at water 2 so that the sigma star can overlap efficiently with water 2's N orbital once again.